To improve the low birth rate, Taipei City government plans to increase maternity allowance from 20,000 to 40,000 NT dollars for firstborns.
With a loud and clear cry comes another new life, yet the low birth rate remains a difficult issue. Taipei City government plans to increase maternity allowance from 20,000 NT dollars to 40,000 NT dollars for firstborns, the highest in the nation.
生育奖加倍送，就第一胎4万，第二胎4万5，第三胎5万。
The Civil Affairs Bureau proposed two plans, awaiting Mayor Jiang Wan-an's decision on whether to implement starting April this year or backtrack to apply to babies born on or after December 25, 2022. Looking at changes in the total population in Taipei in recent years, sliding downward from 2.66 million in 2018 to dropping below 2.5 million in 2022. Subtracting those who were removed from household registration due to COVID-19, the decreasing birth rate is too a main factor. There were still almost 20,000 newborn babies in 2018, yet only 14,000 or so in 2022, down by 8,000 some. However, will increasing maternity allowance really raise people's willingness to give birth?
不会耶，毕竟一开始只有4万嘛，但是后续的花费还是
Taiwan's birth rate is dropping at a rate faster than many other countries. The Awakening Foundation observed that working moms are a very prevalent phenomenon nowadays in society and urged the government to expend a large number of resources in building a friendlier workplace.
第一个，你要必须在制度上，就是支持男性要参与照顾；再来，公共托育的比例是要必须在短期内快速的拉上来；再来，就是友善职场的改革。政府能够推动所谓的弹性请假的制度。In
addition, the Awakening Foundation noted that in the past 5 years, given the increase in child and nursery care demands for 3 years and younger, and limited child caring policies for 0 to 2 year olds. The inability to meet the needs of the people causing working females to have to juggle between work and child rearing, hence naturally giving rise to more unwillingness to have a child.